So this is a activity that I developed for my students to allow them to collect some simulated data for rates of reaction, as we can't carry out the actual practicals in the lab at the moment. So it's a nice simple simulation. It allows them to put particles in a box, different numbers of particles, and they're randomly entered into the box with random velocities. So they move in different directions with different speeds at the start. So it gives you a good idea of some real life data. Once they set it up, they put the however many particles they want in the box, hit go, and the particles start to move around, and they will form a diatomic molecule when two of them collide. So up the right hand side, you've got a reaction completion chart. So that goes from 0 to 100%. And it times it in picoseconds. So it's a relatively realistic simulation of how this reaction would occur. So what I did is I set up a spreadsheet for the students. Well, they set it up themselves, but you can get them to do it, because part of the idea I wanted was to help them develop their spreadsheet skills. It's something that they struggle with a bit later on. So I wanted to get this earlier on in their chemistry education. So show them how to set up a spreadsheet. Left hand side, we have the number of particles from 10 to 50. That seemed to be a good range for this first try through. We did 5 repeats because you get quite a lot of variability in the times taken for completion. And I went for 70% completion. 50%, it seemed to complete very quickly. And so we had quite a lot of error in the response time and hitting the pause. 100% completion, it tends to extend quite a long time, some of the reactions, because you just had waiting for the last two particles to find each other. So I went for 70% completion. We did a mean average of the 5 repeats for each value for the number of particles. And then I just calculated rates as 1/time. So having shown them how to set it up and they collected their data, we then plotted graphs of number of particles as the independent variable and rate as the dependent variable. And that just used the graph plotting within Excel. So I showed them how to do that as well. And adding a trend line allowed them to see that there was a proportionality between number of particles and the rate of reaction, which was the outcome that I wanted them to get from this particular introduction to rates. Extending it, we can allow them to go up beyond 50 particles. So you can add 60, 70, 80 particles, and they could take the extension there and see whether the trend continues. And you could carry it down. There's the button to add just 2 particles in at a time. So you could extend it down to fewer particles. You could also look at whether 50% completion or 100% completion are better endpoints, and whether you get similar trends there. And there is a separate simulation which looks at how temperature affects rate of reaction. So it's fixed at 10 particles, and then you can change the temperature from low to high and equivalently wait for the reaction to complete. So all the full instructions are included in the article, and a copy of the spreadsheet with some sample data, and I hope you find this useful with your students. Have a good day.